Assalamu alaikum and good morning. Welcome once again to online session. Today's topic is vocabulary in the life and diary of Anne Frank. From your adapted reader, we have this drama. Today we will talk about some vocabulary. The first word, along with the words, you would find phonetic transcription, and the words would be in red and the meaning would be underlined, and there would be possibly an example and a sentence. So the first word we have angel. In phonetic transcription you can see angel, it's a noun. The meaning of angel mean in religion a spirit or messenger from heaven. Example, sometimes I'm sure that there is an angel watching out for me. Word number two, certainly. Certainly is an adverb which means without any doubt. I will certainly be glad when school is out for the summer. Sentence number three. For word number three, disturb. Disturb is a verb which means to bother or interrupt someone. My sister and I have agreed never to disturb each other during telephone calls. The next one, flooded. Flooded is a verb which means became filled with. My heart was flooded with happiness when my dog came home. Next one is instantly. Instantly is an adverb which means right away, at once. As soon as I saw him, I instantly knew something was wrong. Possible. Possible is an adjective, able to be done. Likely to happen. Is it possible for me to take the test again when I'm not sick? Next word, privacy. So privacy is a noun, the state of being alone. It's hard to have privacy when you share a bedroom. Next word, shield. Shield is a verb to protect someone or something. In this bright sunlight, you need a hat to shield your eyes. Blunt. Blunt is an adjective which means speaking in an honest way that can upset people. So the example, Kate was so blunt about Tom's bad voice that he stopped singing. Next word, excelled. Excel is a verb which means did something very well. Jenny loved math and excelled at algebra. Next word is permission. So you have to stress on mish, as you can see in phonetic transcription, it's a noun. Permission, it means the act of allowing someone to do something. So the example would be like that. Don't we need permission to camp in that park? The next word is recall. Recall is a verb which means to remember something. I could not recall whether Joe or Celia borrowed my hockey stick. The next word is saucer. Saucer is a noun, so the stress would be at the first syllable. Saucer is a noun which means a small round plate on which you put a cup. So example, the set of dishes came with an extra saucer in case one got broken. The next one is sensitive. Sensitive is an adjective, so you have to stress on the first syllable, sensitive. It means easily upset or offended. Example, I was sensitive to any criticism, even if it really was helpful. Unjust. Unjust is an adjective which means not fair. People held a protest saying that increase in bus fares was unjust. The next word, wandering. Wandering is a verb which means not focusing, moving from thing to things. So the example would be like, my mind was wandering while Mr. Evans talked about gravity. The next word is absorb. Absorbed is an adjective which means greatly entrusted within minutes. He was completely absorbed in the movie. Next word, bolt. Bolt is a noun which means a piece of metal that you slide across a door to lock it. I heard Aunt Louise slide the bolt locking the front door for the night. The next word is canal. So canal is a noun which means man-made passage for boats. To dig a canal deep enough for ocean-going ships is a huge task. Next word is linen. Linen is a noun which means household items made of cloth, such as sheets and napkins. My least favorite chore is ironing the table linen. The next word is positions. Position. So we have three syllables. You have to stress the middle one. Zish. Position is a noun which means things that you own or belongings. I often think we all should give half of our positions to the needy. The next word is sprawling. Sprawling is a verb which means spreading out. Sprawling instead of sitting on the furniture is not polite. The next word is threadbare. Threadbare is an adjective which means thin because of so much wear or use. I noticed the elderly man shivering in his threadbare jacket. The next word is uncertainty. So uncertainty, the stress would be on the second syllable, and it's a noun which means feelings of being unsure about how some things will end. I have lots of uncertainty about the team's ability to win. Next word, animation. So animation is the stress on the second syllable, and it's a noun which means energy and excitement. Kate's personality, so full of animation, made people enjoy being around her. The next word is awkwardly. So the stress would be on the first syllable and it's adverb, awkwardly. It means in a clumsy or uncomfortable way, often due to embarrassment. So the example would be, the young couple awkwardly danced to a slow song. The next word, cellar. Cellar is a noun which means a room under a house. People often use a cellar as a place to store things. This house has a large cellar which is excellent for storage. The next word is contracts. Contracts is a noun which means written agreements, especially legal ones. So the example would be like, John reviewed the contracts to be sure they were ready to sign. The next word is downcast. Downcast is an adjective which means very sad or upset. As our vacation drew to a close, I became downcast. This just will be on the first syllable. The next one is remarks. Remarks is a noun which means things that are said or convinced. The speaker's remarks after the speech were more interesting than talk itself. The next word is rigid. Rigid is an adjective which means stiff and not moving. I became rigid when I heard the rattles of a snake in the bushes. The next one, standstill. Standstill is a noun which means hard with no movement. Our plans to build a clubhouse are at a standstill until we get some wood. Coming to homework, their students study the drama from the beginning to the end with comprehension and check further difficult vocabulary in the drama during reading and write meanings to those difficult words. Thank you very much and have a nice day.